it's Fran again in the lab thing. So, wanted to give an update of, you know, where FranLab is right now going into 2022. As of right now, all of the fixtures have been installed in the lab, office, and in the studio, although some work is still to be done in the studio and office. But it was a monumental task just getting all of this stuff into a significantly smaller space. it all ended up being very vertical, and that process took a lot of time and money. Currently, the last couple weeks, I've been working on the painting, screening, coating room over at the factory. That room sort of just ended up becoming like an abandoned storage dump through the move. It had been sealed off during the pandemic. I didn't have access to the room because it was public space and everything. So stuff ended up getting piled in there during the move, and it's just a dirty sort of, you know, disorganized room. And there's no air conditioning in that room yet. So I've been spending time trying to get the electric in there so that I can run a high capacity air conditioner. But the past couple weeks has been over 95 degrees every day in Philly, and that room is on the top floor, and so it's got the roof, and it's just like an oven in there. And it's actually been too hot for me even to work in there to get the installation of the air conditioning in, so I'm just kind of waiting for it to cool down enough for me to actually put the air conditioning in so that I can begin to organize that space and use it. People have been asking me about how my pilot's license is going, but I've said it in the, you know, the social media channels that I've had to abandon it. It just that the move came. Before the move, I was a third of the way to getting my pilot's license, and the move came, and it's just the money's not there, the time's not there. I cannot afford it on any level anymore. The people who watch my channel also watch Scott Manley's channel, and Scott Manley got his pilot's license, so kudos to him. But it's just not something I'm going to be able to do. It just, you know, the additional $17,000 and, you know, 4 months or so of time, it just isn't there. I got to work. I got to do this, and you know, the money's not there. I don't know if I'll ever be able to afford it. But anyway, so there it is. A goal for this year is to, once again, try to get the funding for FranLab back up to 100%. Things are a little more expensive now, but also I lost a lot of support over the course of the move. It's, you know, 8 months, 10 months. This whole journey has been to get to this new space. So in the process, it's like 15% short on funding overall just to get ends to meet, so that's going to be another thing. I'm going to have to do campaigns, maybe some other things, merch or something, I don't know, but there's still some money left from the savings from before the move, but, if I can't get the channel to be sustainable in the next 6 to 12 months, it's going to be a big trouble. So yeah, I want to try to get Patreon to 100% by the end of the year. That's a goal. Other projects have started again. I completed my Mylar Day Pen project, and there's another project that's a top secret one. It's in the office. I learned my lesson not to talk about long arc projects because very famously had one or two sort of taken out from under me from people who had more resources and more time than I have. So yeah, I've got all these long arc projects, and people have been commenting, Fran, when are you gonna do projects again? When are you gonna do electronics again? You don't do it anymore, you do show films and blah blah blah. Well, I'm doing them, but I just can't show them to you until it's done. The pen project, that was like 2 months, you know, and I've got other ones I'm working on, but I'm not gonna talk about them, because if I talk about them, other people are just going to put all their time and money into it and beat me to the punch, and then I'm going to be out of luck. So, yes, working on projects. Can't show you much, unfortunately. Yeah, I plan on still doing my weekly live broadcast where, you know, I do a lot of the updates and sort of smaller things that really aren't, like, dedicated video-worthy. I'll do that on the live cast. And I will have some projects. I've cleared out room here to do some of the larger show and tells that I just didn't have enough room on the bench for. So I'll be doing that over the next few weeks. Things are piled up here in the lab that I want to show you, and like I said, projects in the works that are going on. Another probably to the end of the month before I get the painting screening room refurbed and reorganized and cleaned up, because it's a total mess in there. And the shop floor at the factory, it's a very dirty floor. There's lots of people working on that floor. There's a lot of metal dust, wood dust and stuff. And so that room, that back room, it wasn't sealed off. And so it is just basically just, there are piles of dirt on everything. And it's like dirt. It's like, you can't like vacuum it off. It's like metal dirt and stuff. It's just, so the whole place needs to be reorganized. Everything has to be cleaned. But I gotta get the air conditioning in there, because it's lethally hot. And so, but I'll get that done. And so I've got projects to do over there. I got more projects to do at the factory. I got stuff that I bought before the pandemic that I received during the pandemic that I still have not opened up and still have not done videos on. I got a whole like Shaper workstation that I didn't even assemble, even though I ordered it before the pandemic. And after you know, I pre-ordered it, and when it finally arrived, the pandemic was on and I couldn't even open it up because I couldn't use the space over at the factory, and that's still sitting there. I have this whole film project that began in like 2018. I got in on a Kickstarter for this amazing new kind of pack film. It took them like 2.5 years to complete the Kickstarter project. So they actually completed it during the pandemic, but because of shipping issues, you couldn't import stuff, during the pandemic for a long time. So the stuff, the film stock, it was actually stuck in Europe and couldn't even come to North America for like 6 to 8 months. And so by the time I got it was years after I bought it in the Kickstarter. And by the time I got it, I was already in the process of the move late last year. And it's in a crate, still waiting to do a video on it. There is a cascade. There are a long list of things like that. The eviction, the move out of the lab 2.0 happened right at the end of the pandemic. It was just a 1-2. So I am years behind, and I know people are patiently waiting for me to get back to form like in the lab 1.0, but it's there have been significant obstacles for me doing that. My life and work for the past 4 years, it's been a shake and bake. It's like everything I do and everything that I have has been like, it's been like a Lego kit in a washing machine. It's just like half of the parts and things that I have, I don't even know where they are, because they've been reorganized and repacked and reshipped and restored so many times in the last 4 years that I've lost track. It's like I said in the live broadcast last week that I still have a very good mental picture of where everything was in the lab 1.0. All the parts, all the supplies, I knew where everything was in the lab 1.0. And in my mind, when I think of, oh, where is this item now? I know exactly where it was in the 1.0. But from breaking down the 1.0, having to cleave off stuff into storage, move everything into the 2.0, and then having to break down the 2.0 and put more stuff into storage and reorganize everything yet again for the 3.0. Yeah, it's just, it's going to take years for me to get back on track. I can't overstate how much of a big thing this has been. Two evictions, two moves in 4 years, and the pandemic in the middle, and I had to finance it all by myself, and keep the channel going and somehow keep my patronage up. It's amazing that it's even held together. And I'm very thankful for all the support that I get on the Patreon. I just need to get a little bit more, and gradually we're gonna get back to the FranLab that you used to know. That's it, that's the update for where we are at FranLab in 2022. you know, the summer of 2022. And the heat in Philly has been just, yes, we always have hot summers in Philly, but when I was a kid, it used to be we'd have heat waves. There'd be like a couple days where it'd be like over 100 degrees. So every now and then it would hit like 110, 112 degrees, like for a day. And then we'd get a, you know, thunderstorm, it would cool off and it would be in the 70s again. You'd have hot days, but you'd also have cool days. But for years, it is 95 degrees every day. And then it rains like a torrent. And then it's 95 degrees every day. And then it rains like a torrent. And then it's 95 degrees every day. There's just no break. And it's just, you know, that's the way it's been. So it's been hard for me to get out and get stuff done. But making use of the time being sequestered here, I've been getting a lot done. Can't show you much. Again, I gotta keep the stuff secret until I'm ready to publish, but hopefully you won't be disappointed when you see my work. I will come through. I always do. Okay. Anyway, that's it. Thanks to all the patrons down there in the Patreon. Couldn't do any of this without you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone on Patreon. And I will be back here in the lab real soon. I'm Fran.